think I'm crazy, and others think maybe they're right. Cause I walk around with a Bible in my pocket and I pray to God every night. I don't care what they may think, I never did listen to them. Still sitting around just waiting on the devil, I started hunting him. They call me the devil hunter, I put him on the run. My camouflage is the blood of Jesus and the word of God in my gun. They call me the devil hunter, I put him on the run. My camouflage is the blood of Jesus and the word of God in my gun. God of love. I know that it's true, but I'm telling you, I think that I've had enough. The disease of sin keeps spreading around, bringing God's people woe. I think it's time we take authority and all let the devil know. They call us the devil hunter, we put him on the run. Our camouflage is the blood of Jesus and the word of God is our gun. They call us the devil hunter, we put him on the run. Our camouflage is the blood of Jesus and the word of God is our gun.
Greetings to you, friends and neighbors. Greetings in the name of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ. This is Brother Ricky Duck, and we're bringing you the Bread of Life streamcast and streaming live from Hickman, Kentucky on this date of April the 18th, 2022. This is program number 126, and our subject matter today is America's destruction. Praise God. First thing, I want to give you a cordial invitation to come out and give us a visit at the Church of Jesus Christ located at 1205 High Street, Union City, Tennessee. Our service weekly is on the Sabbath at 2 p.m., which is Saturday, and except I believe this Coming Friday, we have the new month service. And the services we have are in the scriptures. And they're God's calendar of events for salvation for whole humanity, not just Israel. At the Church of Jesus Christ, we represent and teach the basic doctrines, the true doctrines of repentance. And repentance is repenting from sin. I throw this question up. What is sin? Transgression of the law, according to John. So you're repenting from your transgression. And the second step is to get water baptized in the name Jesus Christ, and that remits your sins. Regardless of the false theology you hear in our day, friend, that baptism is what remits sins. Like Peter said, baptism doth now save us. I believe that's Apostle Peter's words, the man with the keys. Also, we teach receiving the baptism of the Holy Ghost, and when you do, you will speak with tongues. Somebody said, why? That's a gift. Now, I believe Jude stated that everybody's supposed to pray in the Spirit to build up your faith. And the Bible teaches by Apostle Paul, when you pray in spirit, your understanding is unfruitful. Nobody understands you. However, Paul said, but when you do speak in tongues, you're speaking to God. So it's the Spirit inside that gives you the utterance, and that is better than a cell phone when communicating with the Lord. Also, Godhead, we teach Jesus Christ, like Peter did, a man approved of God, and how God has raised him from the dead, give him all power in heaven and earth, and at the end of time, according to Apostle Paul, he's going to give that kingdom back to God, what the Bible said, 1 Corinthians 15:24 through 28. And we teach to honor God's calendar, the feast days, as I said. Somebody said, well, they got that Sinai, and that's done away with. Actually, you go back and look and see if they didn't get the Passover Feast of Unleavened Bread while they were in Egypt. They wasn't even in Mount Sinai. And, of course, that was instituted, and that's God's counter of events. Also, we reject all the pagan holidays. Some of y'all just got through celebrating one yesterday. It's a devil day. It's not Jesus Christ. He couldn't do it and wouldn't do it. If he'd have honored that day, he would have broke Deuteronomy chapter 12, and he wouldn't have been worthy sacrificed, because that's a sin to take pagan customs and put it in your religious service to honor the Lord with. So it's still the same today. It's called sacrilege. And Mr. Babylon's full of it. It's abominations. She's a full abomination of the earth. Her daughters are called harlots. And God said for his people to come out. Jesus gave me a vision in the 70s to call you out of those places. And if you don't hear that, your problem at the judgment. Praise God. Strong, ain't it? He didn't tell me to bring in the feather duster. He told me to come in, don't fear their faces, what the Lord told me when I was in West Hickman Church of Jesus Christ. Praise God. What he told me then, meant it then, means it now. And also we teach keeping the commandments of God, which includes not eating the unclean, because I believe Paul done told Isaiah when Christ returned, he going to kill everybody eating swine. That's what the Word said. Now, I don't know what your denomination teaches. That's what the Word said. And we keep the commandments of God, including Sabbath as well, because Paul took the vow and proved he kept the law. That's what he said. Said he proved he kept it. Now, either that vow was a fraud or else he kept it. One of the two. Can't have them both. Anyway, we teach those things because it's the Word of the living God. Amen. Praise God. Now, let's get right into our subject matter for today. Praise God. Because I guarantee you one thing about it for sure. All of you, including me, is going to partake of this coming up. Praise God. It ain't good news here. Not this ain't good news, not the United States. Praise God. Amen, amen. Let me let me see what I got here. Bring this up. Oh, I hit the wrong one there. I brought in the internet. I don't want the internet. Praise God. Let me back this up to the beginning here, and we will click it on. Praise God. All right, now we got it. We're ready to switch it over. Praise God. America's destruction. Now, some folks say, you should say that. That's bad news. Well, our Lord God Almighty said he would do nothing except he revealed it first to his servants, the prophets. I'm going to list you some folks that prophesied these things and what their prophecies were back in the 50s. And a couple of them, I don't know when they lived, so I can't say for sure on that. And also, I do know what I've got tapes. If I ever dig them out and find the exact spot where Brother Terrell's vision showed about the destruction of the United States, along with what God showed me back in 1989, is to give warning to the people, to those that will hear and heed, Praise God. Now I'm going to start off with an introduction here. It's a depiction of a nuclear war. Now I'm going to tell you, anything you see in these little clips I'm going to show you, the real thing is going to be, I don't know how many fold worse than this. Praise God. So let me click this and we'll just watch this right here for a second. Praise God. All right, let me get switched over here. Praise God. All right, let me move me out of the way so it won't be a distraction here. All right, that was just a little clip to kickstart us into this, and you can see that was a depiction of a 50 megaton bomb hitting one of the cities of the United States, and it was just out of one of the movies of the past. It was kind of scary, but it ain't nothing like the real thing fixing to be. And also, Let me say this before we move on, show you other clips later on down the thing here. Give you a kind of thing to balance this thing out here. The nuclear bomb that hit Hiroshima and Nagasaki, Japan, was 2.5 megaton. Okay, catch that number, 2.5. The biggest nuclear weapon the United States has in its arsenal. It's 38 megaton. The ones Russia uses, and I'm presuming China as well, is 50 megaton. One bomb can take out New York City easy. One bomb. Now, also, let me say this. Years gone past, Russia had a 100 megaton bomb. They were going to test it in their country, like all countries do back in years gone by. And they chickened out and backed out for the very reason they thought they might blow up their own country with it, 100 megaton. Now, President Putin of Russia has said they have a 200 megaton on those underground, what you call them things, like the fire and air. It's not a torpedo. I guess it is in some way. But it can go through the ocean at pretty fast, swift speeds. And they got 200 megaton on some of them and 100 megaton on them. So you can imagine what that would do to the American fleet if it got within so many miles of it. And Christ did warn about the roaring of the sea and all that kind of stuff taking place in the last days. And you're going to see in one of these clips here, it mentions an attack of 300 missiles inbound on the United States in this depiction of it here. However, you're going to also see a clip of George Green that worked with the insiders on this. And he said that Russia has 22,000. And I believe in modern day terms now they have 26,000 nuclear warheads and they're aimed at the United States. And I'm pretty sure China does too. So you're going to see as we go through this, I'm going to show you scripture text. I'm going to mention about, well, I'll do it now. Davos meeting year or two ago. They didn't like Trump and all that, you know, and George Soros and Robert Sachs, right in their meeting said the United States is in the way of their new world order reset of this Mark of the Beast thing that they're trying to get going. And, also it mentions in, Paul's writings, only he who hinders will hinder until he is taken out of the way. So, a lot of folks said, well, it's the Holy Ghost. No, Holy Ghost ain't going to leave. And so it's a church. No, church ain't going to leave. They're going to be here the last day. I know your false theology tells you you are, but you're going to be surprised later on because you're not leaving. You're not going nowhere until the time comes at the seventh vial pouring out when Christ returns at that time. That's when you're going to rise to meet him in the air, if you are in, that is. So only he who hinders until he is taken out of the way. Also, you find the one that developed the Mark of the Beast system thing was the one that's in Revelation 13 says it's the second beast. And it's just it does an image the first beast. Now, the first beast is the one we've all been read about from Daniel's days up to now, 7 head, 10 horns. And yet there was a second beast. You don't see it no more after chapter 13. Also, the United States has bragged about how we're going to back Israel if anybody messes with them. When you look at the end time events in Revelation, you do find Russia and China there, but you don't find the United States there coming to their aid. The only one comes to their aid is when Christ appears in the sky in flaming fire. He comes to their aid, but there is no other nation coming in there with planes, etc., like we have bragged about. So there's a reason why the United States is fixing to be destroyed. We're wicked. We speak, two horns like a lamb. Republican Party, Democrat Party, powers that rule this nation here. And we appear as a lamb. And we talk good stuff and do some good deeds. On the sideline, we do evil deeds as a nation. And because when we pass laws, our laws are contrary to God's laws. That's why we speak as a dragon, as a USA does. Because you've got the gay society. I mean, the government's pushing that. If you in your heart to say anything about it, you're being bad and mean and all that. If you quote scripture in some places, they'll throw you in jail for quoting scripture about that. And so Jesus said it'd be like that in the last days. And our government has passed laws to back anything that's satanic. Murdering of babies, homosexuality, man with man, woman with woman, and all of that. That's approved by the United States laws. So we speak as a dragon. This country is getting set for its worst. I mean, we're going to get it worse than anybody in history ever got it. And the only place that's going to give you a little light is going to be blessed areas where God has a place prepared for his people. And the United States has about approximately 200 of them. And back in the 70s, I believe it was, he showed me one would be in base 4 in Missouri. And I've told that before. I'm not going to go through that. But there's places. However, while you're in Mr. Babylon, you're going to do as Mr. Babylon does. As in Rome, as Rome, as in Mr. Babylon, as Mr. Babylon. And you're going to follow her doctrines. And the Lord said, if his people don't come out of her, what's going to happen to them? They're going to partake of her sins, first of all. And like y'all did yesterday on that Easter thing, that's pagan, demonic, and everything else. And you're teaching your kids that. And that is wrong, dead wrong. Well, you've got one preacher here telling you about it. Your others may sucked up to you on it and want your money out of your pocket. You know, that's all they want. That's what some of these denominations want. That's why some of them become preachers, because they say, oh, that's easy living. I can just go out there and learn a little doctrine from my college and come back and be some kind of a preacher and be dignified, have my judges come to my church, have lawyers come to my church, have the big shots come to my church, sit back on the easy street and just take it easy. That's most of your ministry right there. They wouldn't holler. They would, if they was a guard dog, they wouldn't bark if a criminal man was coming around trying to steal you blind. They'd be hush mouth. Praise God. All right. Anyway, we about to get on the subject. America's destruction. Let's move it on. Here in 1989 is a night vision the Lord God gave me. One of the strangest one I've ever had. And I've had several. It was about nuclear war. I'll read it rather than just tell you about it. I could tell you about it, but I'm going to read it here. 1989, I received this night vision of an angel standing before me saying, and I yellow-lighted words that he spoke, come, I will show you something. I was taken to a high place. Of course, scene just changed, you know. I mean, I can't describe how it just changed, like a TV screen fades out and getting something else. And I was taken to a high place overlooking the earth. Again, he was facing me and said these words. You are living in the day of nuclear war. He looked out a window. That's what I thought it was. Looked to his right, anyway. I looked to my left. I saw pillars of mushroom clouds rising from all over the earth. I said earth because I presume it was earth. However, now, more hindsight and more of this other understanding, I believe since I am an American in America, he was showing me the United States. Man, they was mushroom clouds everywhere, rising up above the clouds. I was above the clouds. I was watching them rise up. And I looked back at him. He said this one word. He said, warning. And the vision ended. Now, I'm going to flash through and read these because they're hard to see. I'm going to play the clip with them in a minute. But first, let's go through. There's three here of A.A. Allen in 1954. You read with me, I'll read this one. A.A. Allen vision said, I saw from the Atlantic and from the Pacific and out of the Gulf rocket-like objects that seemed to come up like fish leaping out of the water. High into the air, they leaped, each headed in a different direction, but every one towards the United States. On the ground, the siren screamed louder. Now, this was 1954. I don't know when they developed that submarine launch missile, but I don't believe they had that in 1954. So he said he just seen it leap up out of the water. If you've seen clips of them ships firing from the ocean, they come out of the water and then they kick, then that main engine kicks and fires and then they go off to their target. That's what he saw in a vision in 1954. He said, up from the ground, I saw similar rockets begin to ascend. That's their anti-missile rockets, our weapons of defense. To me, these appeared to be interceptor rockets. Again, 54, we didn't have them. And there appeared interceptor rockets, although they arose from different points all over the United States. However, none of them seemed to be successful in intercepting the rockets that had risen from the ocean on every side. These rockets finally reached their maximum height, slowly turned over, and fell back toward the earth in defeat. Let me say this right here. At one time, we had weapons that they done displayed that could shoot down missiles in flight. Now, United States and Russia, and I guess China as well, because usually when one gets it, we've got some quislings like the Bidens that sell us out, the Clintons would sold us out, and all that stuff. And friend, that's been proven, so ain't no need worrying about what I spoke truth or not. I know I did. And they'll do that for money, for whatever it is, as long as they're serving the New World Order. Their main purpose is to get rid of the United States because we are in the way as long as we stay in the mode that we were in. They're changing us best they can. But anyway, we had interceptors that could get the ICBMs in flight. They take 30 minutes to get here and so forth. Now they've got the hypersonic, they call it. And I do know from the submarines, once fired, it takes only 5 minutes to hit its target. And I want to say it, I can't have it. President Biden, supposedly the president's the one that has the authority to give the okay to push that button in retaliation, right? Friend, I know this is a joke, but it's almost truth if it ain't truth. I'll just say maybe or perhaps he seems that way, that it takes him 10 minutes to figure out what day it is. So if it takes only 5 minutes when they fire one, he's got to figure out what we got to do. I mean, he may turn around and shake somebody's hand that ain't even there. I mean, I don't know, man. We are in serious problems. And I know Brother Terrell spoke one time and said that there was a time coming that we was helpless for 48 hours. Now, there's more behind that. Something's going to happen to cause that, too. And anyway, said these rockets fell back. They missed their targets, and so those missiles came on. Then suddenly the rockets, which had leaped out of the ocean like fish, all exploded at once. The explosion was ear-splitting. The next thing which I saw was a huge ball of fire. The only thing I have ever seen which resembled the thing I saw in my vision was a picture of the explosion of the H-bomb in the South Pacific. In my vision, it was so real, I seemed to feel the searing heat from it. Now, that's A. Allen vision, 1954. And now we got a man named John W. Johnston. Now, I don't know what year he lived. I don't even know nothing about these guys. I just picked up on their prophecies, and it all fit of what's fixing to happen. This man here said, I saw 5 nuclear missiles, long-range, intercontinental ballistic missiles, to my right and to my left. A total of 10 missiles. Each one carried multiple warheads with a red communist star on the fuselage of the missiles. The 5-pointed red star is a universal representative symbol for communism. At the time of this vision, Russia had a red star on their flag. China still does. I feel in my spirit that these will be Russian missiles. God gave me, and John, he said, God gave me a vision of a massive army coming down on America. I saw the troops killing children and infants with their bayonets. I saw the American people tormented beyond imagination. The troops were void of emotions. Their objective is to take the nation and take it hands down. Now, I had a night vision seeing Chinese soldiers hunting us down back in, I guess it might have been 86 when it was, I think it was. At the end of that vision, there was an illuminated sign said, Made in China. And I saw these Chinese soldiers. Now, I'm going to play a clip along this after a while that China's done let Canada know years ago. They said, we're coming down to America, invade America, and either you can basically get out of the way or be taken in with it. And so again, that army, and I believe on the news here a while back, less than a year ago, military intelligence has said it appears China is preparing for war with America. Friend, that is absolute fact. Listen to this. God raised up Chaldea to punish Judea. God raised up Assyria to punish the 10 tribes of Israel because of their rebellion and their refusal to obey the laws of Almighty God. The United States has, God has raised up a nation, China, to punish America for our sins and our rebellion against God. Every time you partake of a pagan holiday, you are in rebellion. Every time you refuse to obey the commandments of Yahweh, our God Almighty, you're refusing to keep the commandment of the Sabbath, you are in rebellion. Every time you eat pork and swine and unclean animals, you are in rebellion of the laws of God. You don't listen to what I said about Paul took the vow to prove he kept the law. You see things he wrote and take it that he wrote against it. Friend, if he took the vow, he kept the law. If he kept the law like they said, then also he didn't teach against it. So your revelation of scriptures you're using is in error. I've tried to say that. I've tried to tell that. I can prove that. But you've got to have the ears to hear this, or you're going to be caught up in this, and your kids are going to have a bayonet run through them. Maybe yourself as well. And if you ain't killed in the blast, that is. I tell you what, it'd be merciful God if he had you killed when the nuclear blast goes off. Because those left, they're coming in to mop up. China's planning on taking over our breadbasket land and grow the wheat to feed their people. And another thing, as George Green's going to tell you, they have plans on using neutron bombs. I don't think it's just the blast. The neutron bomb will kill everybody in the cities and leave the buildings intact so they can come in later on and bury the bodies and take over what's left as forest property. It's not as bad as the nuclear bomb. Neutron bomb isn't. And I guess the United States has got them too, but we ain't going to need them once we get blown up. So anyway, let's move it on. Dmitry Dudeman. I don't know him. The Russian spies have discovered where the nuclear warehouses are in America. Well, that ain't no doubt. Probably, again, our government sold it to them. The Clintons or the Bidens won. Somebody like them. They're getting rich off of all this. Get in power, take money, sell information they should keep shut. Russian spies have discovered where the nuclear warehouses are in America. When the Americans will think that it is peace and safety from the middle of the country, some of the people will start fighting against the government. The government will be busy with internal problems. Okay, that's a man years ago. What do we got going on in America? BLM. Sponsored by the New World Order, Soros, a white guy that really don't care about BLM. Friend, I'm going to tell you, listen to this, and listen clearly. When the New World Order sets up its agenda with 1 billion people, do you think those folks in the street are on their list to be saved and be in their 1 billion people? Do you think that? Absolutely not. They're being used as pawns to destroy inside. That's the way communism has always worked on a nation. And so those tactics are in play. Whatever they can use to divide the United States, white, black, red, whatever colors we call ourselves, Hispanics and all that, whatever can be used, they're using it. And the bad thing is so many Americans fall for it. And this man here said years ago he saw where the government was busy with internal problems and they were neglected. You know what they're busy about now? What they call that woke stuff? I don't have no idea. I know they ain't awake, but that's what they call it. That's what our military is concerned about. That's what now the Pentagon is concerned about. And we've got an enemy over yonder getting ready to blow us to smithereens. And they're more involved on about when somebody comes in or how you treat his individual person stuff, you know. It's going on just like prophets have said. He said, then from the ocean, from Cuba, Nicaragua, Mexico, he told me two other countries, but I didn't remember what they were. They will bomb the nuclear warehouses. When they explode, America will burn. Now, you wonder why this prophet years gone by mentioned these other countries south of the border coming in here and blowing up the warehouses. President Biden, which is a New World Order person, all the bad stuff he is doing, opening up the border. Listen, I'm not against a good, decent family that comes from another country to better themselves. But that's not what's going on here. These wicked people from different parts of the world have set out plans of what they plan on to do at a certain date. They're synchronizing their time for a certain events. One of them is going to be to blow up the nuclear warehouses. I guarantee you, all them people flooding across the border, all them ain't good family people. A lot of these people are the biggest crooks in the world. They blow. If they're not New World Order, they're funded by them. And you've got the Muslims over there. I guarantee you, they're flooding their people in. and it's the DNC that's doing this. Now, I know you're going to hear a clip in a minute where what's his name that runs the money system told George Green, said, we own both of them, talking about Republican and Democrat parties. I believe that, too. And because they've got that, they just about got this thing sewed up, friend. There ain't nothing anybody do to change it. I'm just putting this out here, letting you know what's fixing to happen. You're not going to have a glorious future, and you go to college, you come back home, you're going to live a cozy life and all that. Friend, one of these days, it's coming to an absolute close. He said, when they explode, America will burn. FEMA, George Green said they're building prison camps all across the United States. If you ever look at FEMA camps anywhere at all, that they've got set up brand new camps. They've got people in them running them, but there ain't nobody in there. There ain't no prisoners in there. If you also look that the Constantino wire is leaning to the inside, not outside. You ever wonder why they do that? Why do they put a Constantino wire in a prison camp? They put it on the side so you can't climb up. You know, ain't nobody trying to break into a prison. And these FEMA camps are set with a barbed wire, Constantino, all that, facing inside. They're not trying to keep people out to protect everyone who's in there. They're keeping people in so they cannot get out. Part of the New World Order agenda, as Celeste Salome said. Also, she said in 2018, I wish I'd kept it. Listen to a video of her. She said when they started this you-know-what thing, she said this is the day they've been waiting for. She said that we'll never go back to normal. She was offered a job as supervisor to decide whether you live or whether you die. That's what she said. She worked with them for 20 years, and when they give her that option there, she walked out on them. Now she's telling them, and she also said there's coming a thing they're going to closed down everything, and that was before they closed down everything. And she said there's going to be a food shortage. The shelves are going to start going bare. Well, friend, what's happening? Walmart, any little store you go to, shorter and shorter. Now, here's my personal assessment, and I think I'm right. George Green made his comment, one of his statements here, there's 129 underground places, well made, like a city, beautiful places. And my assessment is the goods we see disappearing are being stored underground because they know it's just about time for this event. So they're closing everything down. They're taking the goods off the shelf. Not everything at once. You know, they're going to feed you a little, keep you going. And then they're going to put their stock in these underground places to the teeth. Their plans is to destroy everybody above ground. And then when it's over with and we're all done, dead and gone, because their plan's 1 billion people, then after the radiations are over, after other things are done, then they're going to come out and they're going to have a new world order. That is their goal. They plan this to be completely completed by 2050. And there's Agenda 2030, and there's things going on now, friend. It'd bog your mind if you knew it all, and I don't even know it all. I wish I did know it all. Probably scare me more, but these are not conspiracy theories. Somebody said, that's conspiracy. Now, I tell you what, if it is, God started it. If it's a conspiracy theory, then Jesus Christ was involved in it, because he said if he didn't step in, there'd be no flesh saved alive. So he's the one who said it first. So if you want to call it that, you talk to him about it. Now, I'm going to show you a scenario of what a nuclear war might be like. Again, it's just a clip from that scene. And it's nothing like the real thing when it happens. You know, I mean, everybody watched this for 2 hours, and after it's over, we went back to eating sandwiches, watching TVs, everywhere else, and running here and running there. Well, friend, when this nuclear war hits, it's over. There's no cell phone, no computer, no cars, no transportation, nothing. And most likely no food. You got to deal with that in reality when this day hits, if you're still alive. Then you'll have radiation sickness. No doctors, no hospitals. Let's move on. Okay, here we're going to see a scene here of what it might be like, some events of this as it takes place. Praise God. Okay, let me switch it over.
Sir, we need access to the keys and the authentication documents at this time.
Can you get up your key?
Yes, sir.
Adam Baker, could I get a reading, please?
Go ahead, mark it in.
Check your monitor.
I gotta go.
Stand by to copy the message. 85.
Claxon, claxon, claxon. Message followed. Alpha, 7, 8, November, Foxtrot, 1, 5, 2, 2.
Careful. Yes, sir, this is Oscar 11. We just started, sir. Why?
Alpha! We gotta get out of here!
Stand by to copy the message.
Standing by.
Message followed.
That's a GCS execution from the president.
I agree on message valid also.
Step one, launch key is inserted.
Roger.
Let's enable the missiles. Program
Roger.
Select switch. Enable.
Roger.
Flight call. LFO. Unlock code inserted.
Stand by. Unlock code inserted.
Enable switch. Enable.
Enable.
Coordinate. Enable command.
Yes, this is us. We're doing all call enable. Thank you.
Turn on my mark.
95.
5. 4.
They're on their way to Russia. They take about 30 minutes to reach their target.
So do theirs, right?
Missile warning, this is Beale. Confidence is high. I repeat, confidence is high. Roger, we've got 32 targets in track and 10 impacting points. I want to confirm, is this an exercise? Roger, copy. This is not an exercise.
Roger, understand. Major Reinhardt, we have a massive attack against the U.S. at this time. ICBMs. Numerous ICBMs. Roger, understand. Over 300 missiles inbound now.
All right, praise God. Let me get myself back on here with the PowerPoint. Praise God. Okay. Now let's go some scripture text with this. I do believe it's possible for the United States, matter of fact, I believe it will happen, be destroyed before the main nuclear war that we're fixing to read about right here. Revelation 9:18-19, by these three was the third part of men killed, by the fire, by the smoke, and by the brimstone which issued out of their mouths. For their power is in their mouth and in their tails. For their tails were likened to serpents and had heads, and with them they do hurt. Okay, by this event, one-third of humanity is going to be killed. Now, you've seen the depiction showing that when the nuclear missile silo is open, that's a mouth. Remember this. Apostle John don't know the names, what we call them, missiles, weapons, whatever we call them nowadays in time by the terminology we use. He just seen the ground where the thing open up its mouth and fire come out of it. He watched the missile fly rise up out of it with a tail on it. And it says here that power's in their mouth. That's the first initial blast as it comes up. And in their tails as they're flying through the air had fire coming out of it there. Their tails were like serpents. There's that smoke trail. And they had heads. That's the head, that's the missile itself ahead of the smoke trail. And with them they do hurt, killing one-third of humanity. Praise God. Now, let's check out a thing, how they plan to kill us. Because, friend, the United States is number one target for the New World Order. They know that we're in the way. The Freemasons, they're part of completely acknowledging that they are against the United States of America. Now, you go back and do some digging on that. Because your local Masons, they're just people collecting money for the main headquarters. The high echelons of certain degrees worship Satan himself. And I know some say that ain't so. Well, I believe it is. I absolutely believe it is. Now here in 2 Thessalonians 2:7-8, for the mystery of iniquity doth already work. Only he who now letteth, and that the word should be hinder. Only he who now hinders will hinder until he be taken out of the way. So something is hindering the Antichrist, man of sin, coming to his power. It said, when he is taken out of the way, then shall the wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth. So when Jesus come back, this wicked one, he's going to destroy. He's going to take him right, you know, when he's coming back. So this event, whoever's got to be taken out of the way, will happen near the end. It's not Holy Ghost. It's not church. Then shall the wicked be revealed, whom the Lord shall consume with the spirit of his mouth, and shall destroy with the brightness of his coming. So when Christ come back, he's going to slay that wicked one. And it's going to be running the new world order ahead as the Antichrist. And you go, whoever's alive, unless you're in a blessed area, you're going to have that mark on your right hand or forehead. They've got it developed. It's called a certified mark in their terms. And after you get goodly connected, I ain't going to go into that part right there, but they've got a certified mark waiting on everybody that will take it. And since most folks have bowed down this far, why, shoot, you know they're going to bow down and take that. You can't buy or sell without it. Can you imagine what that would mean? You're not going to be able to buy groceries, buy gas, own a car. You rich folks can't do it either. You multimillionaires, you can't do it either. You say, I want to be saved. Well, you can't. You take the mark, you ain't saved. You don't take the mark, all that fancy stuff you got's gone. You just, well, it's over. You can't buy a car, you can't buy a house, you can't pay your house, you can't pay your taxes. So there you are. They're going to put the squeeze on. And what it is, you can't afford to let go. So you're going to bow down and you're going to take this mark. The only ones that won't take it, it's them that's born again of the Spirit of God, have the Holy Ghost. They'll be the ones that have the faith that they can buck this system and tough it out. And it's going to be rough on them. It's going to be rough on everybody. Except God's got a place called the blessed areas. And that's where his people's going to be protected in those days. And ain't nobody going to touch them there. They didn't touch them in Goshen. Same God. God said, I got a place. He gave me a night vision back in the, I believe, 70s. Angel of God in a night vision. Didn't say a word this time. Put his hand on my shoulder, beckoned through the wilderness. And as my eyes focused, I could see my Bible land on top of a clear, crystal stream of water. I went over and picked it up. The vision ended. 3 days later, he gave me a revelation of it. I'd be protected, I'd be preserved in the wilderness by the Word of God. It ain't going to be in a cozy house with air conditioning and stuff like that. Praise God. Now, this right here, if I'm not mistaken, I believe is that what I just showed you about those that prophesied, it's going to re-show it, and then something, I think, at the end. So just bear with me here and view this as well. I know it got a lot of view and all that kind of stuff, but I want you a good depiction of it. Praise God. So we'll get me out of the way here, and we'll bring this other one back up in just a jiffy.
Keep your eyes on China and Russia. Never mind the Middle East. Never mind North and South Korea. Don't worry about these little skirmishes around the world. The very thing they want to get your mind off of is that which is most important. Right now, watch China and Russia.
We got a listener out there that says, what's coming for Canada? And I want to ask you, I had heard some time back that China made its plans known to the Canadian government, and they basically said, we're coming down and going to invade the United States, so either you're on our side or we'll take you along the path.
That's 20-year-old intel, okay?
That's old intel.
Obama let it slip that there's going to be 57 states in the United States. Canada's going to be annexed after that point.
Wow.
And I'll tell you something else. A Canadian general, and he got in a lot of trouble. He was picked up in the clear talking about the stupid Americans. When we come in and dispossess them, we're taking all their stuff.
And I'm here to tell people that the government knows that something is coming, and there is no plan for you and I.
All right, praise God. Amen. And I hope you're getting the audio on this, because there's a possibility I didn't click something. But anyway, we'll still go through it. And if it don't work out right, I'll make one and post it by itself without it being live on YouTube. Anyway, we have a clip here of George Greene assessing and making these statements and comments that we had mentioned. Praise God. So we're going to go into, if I can get my little mouse to work here. Praise God. They don't want to cooperate with me. There we go. All right. Praise God. Let's get this one going.
The problem is the monopoly game, which is controlled by the Federal Reserve, the private bank, which is actually controlled out of London, is manipulating all the dollars to put them out, put more and more people into debt. So the illusion of equity they have in real estate is coming apart. The players that are analyzing everything are expecting massive foreclosures next year and the beginning of what we call the recession it's going to be worse than 29. Okay. It's your house that you're living in. You think
that's
you own it. You don't.
Right.
You have contractual right to transfer the airspace, subject to you paying taxes to the state.
Right.
or the Global 2000 discussions that we had, the real problem that they have, as Kissinger says, is there are just too many people on the planet. And 40% of the world, 2 billion of us, exist on less than $2 a day. The summary of the Global 2000 report I put up on my website, nohoax.com, but if you look at it, it makes sense to get rid of people. So what they said, they're going to make godlike decisions on who lives and who dies. Now, obviously, some of the meetings we sat on, we were planning on using neutron bombs on the major cities, because that contains most of what they call...
You actually heard this?
I said it on the meetings. I was in the game big time. In fact, I was making such a mess, they decided rather than kill me, which they could, they just invited me into the inner group and asked me to be the finance chairman. And at that point, I probably would have been in, you know, Secretary of the Treasury or some, whatever they wanted to do with me. What I was doing prior to that, so, you know, making it right, I would volunteer to become a president of a company, and I'd go in and liquidate it. And we get rid of the expendable containers. That was my job.
Expendable containers meaning human beings?
That's right.
Yeah, it's amazing. That's
the
inside vernacular, wasn't it? Yeah.
Oh, well, that's what we used at that time. I mean, it went from there to useless eaters today, so you're happy with it, you're a human resource. So,
right.
Which, you know, all you are is part of the commodity, even in the business sense. You look at it, you have a cost. Labor, what is labor?
Yeah.
Human resource.
Right.
When you're going to put together some kind of product. Well, the inside of the game, when we started to use neutron bombs, today they figure that biologicals are much cheaper.
Mm-hmm.
They're still planning on, the plan is to get a war started in the Middle East, and they're still planning on using a neutron bomb or one of the bombs that they've got developed on Israel,
mm-hmm.
and that's to begin World War III,
mm-hmm.
which is all in the cards. And it's going to happen.
They
even put a monument up to this whole program. It's mm-hmm. called the Georgia Guidestones.
Mm-hmm.
You know,
outside
of Atlanta,
you know,
and they've got it all set down there. It's all in 8 languages. Basically, it's fait accompli as far as they're concerned. It's just to get the thing going in the Middle East, and it's not going fast enough. I mean, Carter put this thing in, so we have the plan 2000 with the war starting in the year 2000 in the Middle East.
Right.
Reduce the population of the planet down to 500 million, have one world currency under the Homeland Security or FEMA, if you want to call it. They're going to declare an emergency, which you're going to shut down everything.
Uh-huh.
My friends, my CIA associates, I don't even call them friends anymore. CIA is crooks in action.
Yeah.
They're all professional liars.
Yeah.
I mean, they got to be if they have that job.
Yeah.
So you have to look at what they're doing. Anyway, they're so concerned, they're leaving the country too. Most of them are going to Latin America. Meanwhile, they're closing in. Every day right now, just closing in to make it so we're going to be set up in these enemy prisoner war camps. I published a book. It's called Chaos in America.
Mm-hmm.
In it, I was asked to build an enemy prisoner war camp. I put the contract in this book. So you can read it for yourself. This is in downtown Las Vegas, right on the railroad tracks. It says enemy prisoner war camp. They're all on top. And they're building them all the way across the United States right now. Bush signed an executive order taking the old forts and the army places that we shut down to get those organized to hold the so-called dissidents. Now, what's the definition of a dissident? And the problem is that we're going to enslave ourselves because most of the people want to keep having food coming in, and you're going to follow the line. You're just rocking yourself into your own prison camp. Then we're going to come down to the extermination, just like World War II.
Right.
Well, Phil and I have lectured together. I know Phil's not. He's dead now.
I know he's dead. And so what about what he was saying about the number of bases at that time? I think it was 129 bases before he died. Underground had already been built. Is that all for the elite?
Yeah.
Really?
What are they going to do with the rest of the people? They just get rid of them, leave them above ground and be radiated. Now, my son happens to be a nuclear physicist.
Mm-hmm.
Spent the last 3.5 years in a secret city in Russia. They're about 12 years ahead of us. They have 22,000 nuclear warheads. And of course, we're the target. The Soviets had 3 nuclear submarines on the West Coast and 3 on the East Coast. They're about 2 football fields in length, 5 stories tall, and they all are nuclear power and aimed at our major cities. Westcoast
okay.
gone. Well, because the plan is the Northern Hemisphere is where they're going to release the nuclear bombs, and the theory was
mm-hmm.
that the winds from the North Pole that are coming down, because that's increasing drastically,
right.
will go to the equator, and there will be very little spillover because of the reverse of the winds, because mm-hmm. of the Southern Hemisphere.
Okay.
So therefore, the nuclear radiation here will be a lot more than the Southern Hemisphere.
And this is a fait accompli, you believe?
Oh, they think so. Oh, yeah, they think they won. That's the reason why they don't bother about me talking about it. They don't care whether you know or not. What are you going to do about it? And you have no idea what China is until you go over there for yourself. With a 1,300,000,000, you understand, almost, well, a little over four times our population.
Right.
It's, you know, I spent some time over there with, and I had some government friends. They think they're going to, what they're going to do is let the West go have its fight. And then they want to clean up. They say it's been 5,000 years. We want to run the world when we get through. And what they're doing? Acquiring all the assets.
Mm-hmm.
They figure
yeah,
that
yeah.
Canada and the United States, the property there will, the food growing areas, will be enough to take care of their people.
Mm-hmm.
And that's what they're looking at. Why are they, I mean, they bought
so
oil.
So the U.S. will become a resource. Yeah.
Whatever's left of it.
Whatever's left of it, yeah. You seem to be in a unique position to be able to put a fair amount of this together, which is quite interesting.
Well, I walked my talk. I played the game.
You played the game. You know that you know one level of it.
And I know. I used to play around with the world leaders, so I know what they're planning on doing.
What change of heart? What happened in you that made you decide to share this information that happens at the inside levels?
Well, it come back to a moral situation that happened to me, I think. When I flew to Aspen, I brought my two daughters up there so they could go, you know, go skiing. And I was invited to this meeting, when I walked into the room, the world leaders were there, and that's when they asked me to be the finance chairman. As they said, we'd like you to be the finance chairman for the next president of the United States. And the first thing I asked is, why me? And they said, well, we owe you a favor. Remember I told you I volunteered to be president of companies as
right.
I went down.
And then you liquidate, yeah.
I didn't charge them anything for it. It was just a game.
I see.
And anyway, that's what they said.
So I thought you'd be good on the team, yeah.
I'd be a team player. I just mm-hmm. did it because it was, you know, another one of these things. So next thing I asked them, I said, well, wait a minute. You know, I just started this $100 million project. And they said, don't worry about it. We'll put it on ice. And I said, okay, who with? And I said, well, you can do that. Then I said the next thing was, who is going to be the next president? Now, this is 2 years before he became president.
Right.
And they said Jimmy Carter. And I said, Jimmy who? And they said, well, he's the Democratic governor of Georgia. And I said, I've been voting Republican. And Paul Volcker said, son, don't worry about it. We control them both.
Yeah.
And I said, well, I got the next question is, what does a finance chairman do?
Yeah.
You know, I haven't been doing that. I've been playing all this other stuff. And he said, well, you sit down with Ted. And so I sat over with Ted Kennedy. He's sitting right next to me.
Mm-hmm.
And Ted and I are, you know, he's just joking. He says, George, you're going to love this job. You're really good with money. We're going to send you out to all the state Democratic functions to raise money for the National Democratic Party. I was livid. I really didn't know what to do.
So it was that moment of personal insult.
That was part of it.
Yeah.
I got up and I walked across the room.
Yeah.
I then talked to Pierre Trudeau and his wife, mm-hmm. who was the Prime Minister of Canada
mm-hmm.
at that time.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm sitting in front of them with a little half cigar box full of white powder. And then I'm looking around the rest of the room. I said, my God, something hit me at that point. If the world leaders have to resort to this, I don't think I want to be part of this thing.
Mm-hmm.
I mean, even to the pollution and getting everything else they're talking about, getting rid of all the other people. I mean, I was raised in a packing house and slaughtering animals. And you get to the point where people are just animals at that. And then I found out a little bit more about the details of the Plan 2000, of the annihilation of the entire planet. I said, I got to stop these people. There's something there. I mean, it's just, they got to be stopped.
All right. Praise God. Okay, we are through with that part there. Now let's look at some scripture text to verify those events that's prophesied to come down the pipe. Isaiah 24:4, the earth mourns and fades away. The world languisheth and fadeth away. The haughty people of the earth do languish. Remember what I said a while ago? Don't matter how rich you are. Don't matter how rich you are. I don't care if you got $1 million in the bank. $1 billion in the bank. When this day hits, it's going to hit you like a sledgehammer, like it does everybody else. The whole world is going to languish. The haughty people of the earth, those haughty folks, are going to languish. The fun's over. Fun's going to be over. You ain't getting right with God now, friend. You're almost waiting too late. You're almost waiting too late. Isaiah 24 and 6. Notice this. Therefore hath the curse devoured the earth. They that dwell therein are desolate. That is, people of the earth are going to be desolate. Therefore, the inhabitants of the earth are what? Burned. Burned. When this nuclear war takes place, and the United States is going to have, like a man said, he said back in those days before Carter was elected, by the intelligence folks, 22,000 nuclear warheads aimed at America from Russia. I've heard now there's 26,000. Now, my guess is, I mean, you see Putin of Russia, he don't care to murder and mutilate people, normal citizens, blow their houses up, their places of living, not even military target. So that's the kind of mind, that's the kind of spirit that's going to fire a nuclear weapon with maybe 100 megaton on it, maybe a 200 megaton on it, and it's going to blow this country to smithers. Hypersonic weapons, and most likely who fires first wins. And you know we're not going to fire first. We've got a man right now, wouldn't know where the button's at. So it's fixing to happen, folks. It's fixing to happen. Low down, low life living of the United States people probably got a Bible in every house. Nobody, hardly any except a few, even trying to live by it. They love the world, the things in the world. And God done said, if you do that, the love of the Father is not in you, but you think it is because you can say His name. Well, actions speak louder than words. You love the world. You prove it. You prove it. You go to every sporting event. You go to every concert that's of the world. You go to every place that's of the world. And then you go to church on Sunday, which is the wrong day, not honoring God's days. So, friend, we're wide open for this. We're wide open to this. And if you hear anybody prophesying smooth, that's a false prophet. That is a false prophet. I don't care who. I don't care if he got Acts 2:38. I don't care if he got Torah tacked across that head right there. He's prophesying smooth for America. That's a false prophet if he claimed to be a prophet. Now, he can be misled and misunderstand trying to do good. But if he's trying to prophesy good, friend, the United States has been getting hit. God told me, I know 2 or 3 years ago, there's 3 woes on this nation. I think the third one's coming up. And I guess then it would be what I'm perceiving through all these that's going to happen. Russia, oh, Putin done threatened to push that button. Praise God. Yes, he has. Guess who it's aimed at? All right, but what it says right here, when it's over, the inhabitants of earth going to be burned and few men left. Do you not understand what the implication is? By the time Jesus returns, over half of the world population are going to be laying out on the ground dead and nobody to bury them. That's going to happen. You're going to see it or be in it. Isaiah 24:19, the earth is utterly broken down. The earth is clean dissolved. The earth is moved exceedingly. Praise God. And that ain't just nuclear war. We got that big old Yellowstone National Park thing getting ready to blow. We don't nobody know when. But if it does, from there to here, it'll blanket the earth. In the United States, at least 2/3 of the country with ash. So there's another problem. The end is coming on America. It did Judea. Go back and check them out. See if they didn't cry and bawl and squall while they were having to leave their families and be scattered abroad in Babylon, Assyria, and all that. Go back and check the Jews that lived in Germany in nice houses, how they wound up in extermination camps treated like dirt. You think it won't happen to you because you say Jesus. You ain't even obeying Him. You ain't even keeping the commandments. You're letting your preachers fool you every Sunday. You love it like that. And it's going to cost you. It's going to cost your kids. It's going to cost your grandkids. And most likely while you're watching. When the Chinese come down, they're coming down to mop up. Anybody they find alive, they're going to ban at them or shoot them. God showed me a night vision of that and been trying to find that place of the blessed area and them coming about. Brother Terrell said he saw them on jumbo planes landing on our big highways. You know, them big old long highways, interstate highways, planes landing with Chinese soldiers on them. Seen submarines or boats unloading Chinese soldiers. Others have seen the same. Yet we got a government right now that cares more about a bunch of words. If you say something kind of cockeyed, you know, that's all they're worried about. That's all they're worried about. And the thing is, they're the enemy. God put them there with their agenda to do what they're doing to cause the trouble in the United States. And they're doing their job while you got some good people following, tagging along. BLM is anti-American. It's not of God, never was God, never will be of God. It's of Soros and that band. But let me say this after saying that. I know we have a lot of crooked things that go on in police and government and so forth, and I know a lot of black folks are mistreated on that. I agree with that. But the agenda of that organization is not just for that. That's Soros back, which means he's got an agenda from the New World Order. So don't get me wrong there. I don't believe that any human, black, white, Hispanic, Asian, should be mistreated by the police in any manner or form. Yeah, I've seen clips. I'm going to break off and say this. I've seen clips where a black guy was walking down the street with an AK-47 strapped to his shoulder in a state that you were allowed to carry a weapon. Police come in there about two cars strong, searched that guy, took his weapon, and I think they put him on the ground. Then the guys are setting this up, had a white guy walking down there. He had the same weapon on his shoulder, and all the thing they done, come down there and got out and talked to him a little bit, got back in the car and left. Yeah, I agree, bad stuff's going on the wrong way there. I don't agree with people being mistreated. I don't care who they are. Okay, that's enough on that. I'm about to get off on a tangent on something else. Don't need to do that. Praise God. Okay, look at this. During this time, when this is going on, Isaiah 26, 2021, come, my people, enter thou into thy chambers. Shut thy doors about thee. Hide thyself, as it were, for a little moment until the indignation be overpassed. Blessed areas, God's people, will be protected. He said, for behold, the Lord comes out of his place to punish the inhabitants of the earth for their iniquity. In other words, that word iniquity, for their lawlessness, not obeying his laws. You read back in Isaiah 24, the curse devoured the earth because they transgressed the law. For you people that hate God's law, there it is. The earth also shall disclose her blood and shall no more cover her slain. That's the many bodies laying out there dead during this time. You could be one of them bodies or you could be one alive and looking at it. Could be your family and kids. I'm telling you, friend, your fun time is all, I mean, it's that close to being over with. Whatever you're doing for fun on the weekend. Not trying to serve God. Not trying to get in church. Now, if you want to get in church and get born again, you got to first repent of your sins. Second, get water baptized in the name of Jesus Christ. Get them sins remitted. And then pray until Jesus baptized you with the Holy Ghost and speak in them other languages as it says in the Word of God. Mark 16 and 17. You break it down with the words in the correct language there. It talks about the speaker speaking a word that he don't know. So you want to buck up against that, you're going to wind up not being born again. And then the worst thing is, at the final judgment, what's going to happen to you? You can read that in Revelation. All right, praise God. We have completed that. Praise God. All right. Praise God. So let's get ready to switch this thing over now and get ready to close it out. Praise God. There is coming America's destruction. like I said, NWO folks are saying the United States is in the way. We've got to be moved. Bible says somebody's in the way keeping Antichrist from coming to power. It's going to be moved. The Bible says that second beast in Revelation 13 is one to come up with the system of can't buy or sell without the mark. You don't see it after that chapter. There were two beasts there. This beast had, the second one had two horns like a lamb. And horns represent powers, political powers. And then when it speaks like the devil. And then after it's taken out of the way, then the New World Order sets up its empire, kingdom, with the Antichrist in control, doing his thing. Praise God. So we may not get to see the Antichrist. We may be blown to smithereens. Could happen at any time if he decides to push that button over yonder. You know, it's going to happen. It's coming. They even declaring it's in their plans. It's in their plans to destroy this country. It's in their plans. All right. We're going to get ready. Shut it out. Going to close out on the song. My first one we had on was Devil Hunter. Whoo-wee. Devil Hunter. Devil gets on the run when you start talking about Lord God Almighty's commandments. Mr. Babylon folks had got them demonic preachers. Paul called them that. He called them Satan ministers. And I'll say it again, you need to listen real close to what I'm saying. Jesus Christ said few is going to find eternal life. Guess where the true preacher comes from? He comes from that few or from that many? True preachers coming from that few. True preachers going to be doing like Paul and apostles were. They're going to be not eating unclean. They're going to be keeping Sabbath day and the commandments of Yahweh. That's what the true preachers are going to be doing. Isaiah 8:20 said to the law and to the prophets, if they don't speak according to this word, there ain't no light in them. Oh, you can shout. Oh, yeah, anybody can get down with the music, you know. You can cut a rug. Praise God. But that ain't it. A golden calf day in Egypt, they're out there shouting and dancing to the music. And God getting ready to kill them. And they didn't even know it. He told Moses, you get out of the way, I'll kill every one of them, raise up a nation to you. And there they was out there cutting a rug, dancing to the music. Wasn't listening to the commandments. I know, you ain't going to wake up. That's all right, sleep on. But you're getting a word, you're getting a warning God said for the prophets to do. He said warn them. This is part of it. All right, now we're going to switch over and go to a song called To God Be the Glory. It's a trumpet. And name it, Mary, I forgot his last name, but I'll post all this link on YouTube, then transfer it back to Facebook. So God bless you. May the Lord keep you in safety and health in the name of Yahshua HaMashiach. Amen. God bless.
Just like we were.